Assalamualaikum students, I am your SSC teacher from IYS school. So today we will discuss our chapter, The Story of Pakistan. This is our unit number 18. In your book, page number 73 to 78. Okay, in this chapter we will discuss the events which occurred in different time period and the time of 1857 when the war of independence occurred between Muslims, Hindus and British. We will also discuss on the time about 1600 AD when Europeans and British came to this region. And what is the purpose why they attack on the rulers and occupy their land? And in 1857, the War of Independence occurred, in which Hindus and Muslims were defeated after that. What is the role of Sir Syed Ahmad Khan and who is he? And when and why All India Muslim League Party formed? Okay, also we discuss what happened in 1930. So today we will discuss on these events. So firstly, I'm sharing you on the screen the area, the region of a one country very long ago. India, Pakistan, Bangladesh were called a one country. On this region, there is no separation between Pakistan, India and Bangladesh. Okay? These three countries were called a one country. In this picture, you can easily understand the areas, the boundaries between Pakistan, India and Bangladesh. There is a picture, a map of these three countries, Pakistan, their cities, Gujranwala, Multan, Larkana, Hyderabad. Same as in India, Jaipur, Jabalpur, Lucknow, Agra, Meerut, these all are the cities of India. Same as if we come to the Bangladesh area, the capital of Bangladesh is Dhaka, Kolkata. These all are the cities of these countries. Very long ago, the region now comprising India, Bangladesh and Pakistan were one country, and they were ruled by a Hindu Maharaja. Okay, first of all, we'll discuss about the Pakistan and Bangladesh. Bangladesh was the part of Pakistan. This is called the East Pakistan, and Pakistan was called the West Pakistan. Okay, this is the part of Pakistan. Many different differences developed due to the wrong policies of different government between these two parts of Pakistan. East Pakistan declared its independence in 1971 as Bangladesh. India supported Bangladesh and Pakistan had a war with India. After the war, Bangladesh appeared as an independent country and West Pakistan became the Pakistan as we know today. There is the other reason of separation. In 1971, Bangladesh declared independence from Pakistan because for decades West Pakistani had dominated the country's government and neglected to alleviate conditions for Bengalis in East Pakistan. Why this is the one of the other reason of separation. After that, there is a time very long ago when these three areas, Pakistan, India and Bangladesh, when these three countries were called a one country, they were ruled by the Hindu Maharaja. Then the Muslims came into this region, and after that, Muhammad bin Qasim, who conquered the Sindh, later Muslim rulers established their rule over this region. Muhammad bin Qasim actually was an Arab military commander of the Umayyad Caliphate who led the Muslim conquest of Sindh and Multan from the last Brahman king Raja Dahir in the Battle of Aroer. He was the first Muslim to have successfully captured Hindu territories. The Umayyad Caliphate ordered Muhammad bin Qasim to attack over Sindh. Dahir died in the battle, his forces were defeated, and Muhammad bin Qasim took control of Sindh. In this region, Islam is not spread by sword or by forcing the peoples. Many of the peoples lived there. They inspired with the Muslims' lifestyle. When hundreds of Muslim Sufis came here and lived here to tell the love of God and the love of human beings, the people of this region, they started to become a Muslim. Around the time 1600 AD, on this time, British and European merchants came to this region. They already knew about the wealth of the people, about the land, how much the land is good for cultivation, and the mineral resources, and they also knew the energy resources. This land is actually rich with minerals. So firstly, these merchants, or you can say the traders, carried out the trade. But when the Muslims' local ruler became weak, they started to begin attack them and occupy their. I am repeating here, Islam spread in this region not by sword but with love. Hundreds of Muslim Sufis came here and lived here to tell the people about the love of God and the love of human beings. Many peoples became Muslims when they saw the kind of pious life these saints used to live. Around 1600 AD, the British and European merchants came to this region. They had heard many stories about the wealth of the people living here. At first, they carried out trade, but when the local rulers became weak, the European merchants began to attack them and occupy their land. The British wanted to gain as much profit from trade as possible. The merchants were hoping to break into the spice trade in Indonesia. But the Dutch had already won the control of spice trade and would not allow any other European company to share it. Firstly, the Europeans and the British traders, firstly, they carried out trade, but when the local rulers became weak, they started to begin to attack on them and occupy their land. War of Independence. In 1857, the War of Independence occurred. Many peoples in India, including Hindus and Muslims, joined together to fight a war of independence against the British. But unfortunately, they were defeated and the British removed the last Mughal king from the throne of Delhi. Causes of the failure of the War of Independence is the War of Independence is an important landmark in the history of subcontinent. This war was fought in 1857 by Indians against the British in order to get rid of their domination. It is also given name by Indian rebellions. The main cause of the war were political, social, economical, military, and religious. It was an extreme effort made by Indians and Muslims, but they failed due to certain reasons, including mutual jealousies, disunity, and lack of central leadership, etc. When they were defeated and the British removed the last Mughal king from the throne of Delhi, then Victoria, the Queen of England, became the ruler of all India. This means that India was now a British colony. The British introduced modern education and the system of election for choosing the member of the law-making councils. Hindus were more advanced in education than the Muslims, and they were also in majority as compared to the Muslims. So therefore, they had better chance to becoming powerful under the new system. At that time, Sir Syed Ahmad Khan realized the need of the Muslim and opened a college at Aligarh to educate them. Sir Syed Ahmad Khan was an Islamic pragmatist, Islamic reformer, and philosopher of 19th century. He is considered as the pioneer of Muslim nationalism in India and is widely credited as the father of two-nation theory, which formed the basis of Pakistan movement. He was awarded an honorary LLD from the University of Edinburgh in 1889. There is the picture of Aligarh Muslim University. Who opened it? Sir Syed Ahmad Khan opened for the Muslims. I am repeating here the detail of Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. He was an Islamic pragmatist, Islamic reformer, and philosopher of the 19th century. इज कंसीडर्ड एज द पायनियर ऑफ मुस्लिम नेशनलिज्म इन इंडिया एंड इज वाइडली क्रेडिटेड एज द फादर ऑफ टू नेशन थ्योरी विच फॉर्म्ड द बेसिस ऑफ पाकिस्तान मूवमेंट. He was born into a family with strong debts to the Mughal court. He was awarded an honorary LLD from the university in 1889. In 1838, Sir Syed Ahmed entered the service of East India Company and went on to become a judge at a small causes court in 1867. During the Indian rebellions of 1857, he remained loyal to the British Raj and was noted for his actions in saving European lives. In 1859, Sir Syed established Gulshan School at Muradabad, Victoria School at Ghazipur in 1863, and a scientific society for Muslims in 1864. In 1875, founded the Muhammadan Anglo-Oriental College, the first Muslim university in Southern Asia. During his career, Syed repeatedly called upon Muslims to loyally serve the British Raj and promoted the adoption of Urdu as the lingua franca of all Indian Muslims. Syed criticized the Indian National Congress. Syed maintains a strong legacy in Pakistan and among Indian Muslims. He strongly influenced other Muslim leaders, including Allama Iqbal and Jinnah. When the British introduced the modern education and the system of election for choosing members of the lawmaking council, Hindus were advanced and educated as compared to the Muslims, and they were also in majority. Therefore, they had a better chance to becoming powerful under the new system. Sir Syed Ahmed Khan realized the needs of the Muslims and opened a college at Aligarh to educate them. There is a picture of Aligarh Muslim University or college. In 1906, some Muslim leaders got together and formed a political party for the Muslims. It was called All India Muslim League. Muhammad Ali Jinnah became its member in 1930. In 1906, the All India Muslim League party was formed. Its strongly advocacy for the establishment of a separate Muslim majority nation state, Pakistan, successfully led to the partition of India in 1947 by the British Empire. The party arose out of a literary movement began at the Aligarh Muslim University and was formed in Dhaka. Many years after, Sir Syed Ahmad Khan, the death of Sir Syed Ahmad Khan was central figure for the formation of the university. It remained an elitist organization until 1937, when the leadership began mobilizing the Muslim masses and the League then began a popular organization. 1906, All India Muslim League Party was formed. Some Muslim leaders got together and formed a political party, which is called All India Muslim League. Muhammad Ali Jinnah, a young lawyer, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, a young lawyer and a politician from Bombay, became its member in 1913. There is a timeline on your screen, the years and the events which occurred in the specific years. Around 1600 AD, the British and European merchants or the traders came to this region for the business purpose. Firstly, they carried out trade, but when the local rulers became weak, they started to attack on them and then they occupy their lands. In 1857, Hindus and Muslims fight the war of independence. Many people in India, including Hindus and Muslims, they join together to fight a war of independence against the British. But they were defeated and the British removed the last Mughal king from the throne of Delhi. Then Victoria, the Queen of England, became the ruler of all of India. This means that India was now a British colony. In 1906, All India Muslim League was formed. In 1906, some Muslim leaders got together and formed a political party for the Muslims. It was called All India Muslim League. Muhammad Ali Jinnah, a young lawyer and a politician from Bombay, became its member in 1913. In 1913, Muhammad Ali Jinnah became the member of All India Muslim League. So today we discuss on these starting 4 years and the events which occurred in these specific time. I'm repeating here from the starting, when India, Pakistan and Bangladesh was called a one country and there is no boundaries between the Pakistan, India and Bangladesh. In this picture, in the map, you can easily understand the area of Pakistan, India and Bangladesh. In this map, you can easily understand the cities of these countries. Then Pakistan and Bangladesh. Bangladesh, which was called the East Pakistan, and this is the part of Pakistan, was separated in 1971. There is the one of the other reason of separation. Bangladesh declared independence from Pakistan because for decades West Pakistan Pakistani had dominated the country's government and neglected to alleviate conditions for Bengalis in East Pakistan. Pakistan, India and Bangladesh, they were ruled, there was a one country and they were ruled by a Hindu kings. Then the Muslims came into this region. As I told you about the Muhammad bin Qasim, who conquered the Sindh, was an Arab military commander of the Umayyad Caliphate, who led the Muslim conquest of Sindh and Multan from the last Burman king, Raja Dahir, in the Battle of Arur. He was the first Muslim to have successfully captured Hindu territories. The Umayyad Caliphate ordered Muhammad bin Qasim to attack over Sindh. Dahir died in the battle. His forces were defeated and Muhammad bin Qasim took control of Sindh. Later, the Muslim rulers established their rule over this region. Islam spread in this region not by sword but with love. Hundreds of Muslim Sufis came here and lived here to tell the people about the love of God and the love of human beings. Many people became Muslims when they saw the kind of these fires. Around 1600 AD, the British and other European merchants came to this region. They had heard many stories about the wealth of the people living here. Firstly, they carried out trade, but when the local rulers became weak, the European merchants began to attack them and occupy their lands. War of Independence occurred in 1857, in which Hindus and Muslims joined together to fight the War of Independence against the British. But unfortunately, they were defeated and the British removed the last Mughal king from the throne of Delhi. The British introduced the modern education and the system of election for choosing member of the law-making councils. Hindus were more advanced in education than the Muslims, and they were also in majority. Therefore, they had better chance of becoming powerful under the new system. Sir Syed Ahmad Khan realized the need of the Muslims and opened a college at Aligarh to educate them. In 1906, some Muslim leaders got together and formed a political party for the Muslims. It was called All India Muslim League. Muhammad Ali Jinnah, a young lawyer and politician from Bombay, became its member in 1913. So class, this is your home task. You will make the title page of unit number 18 on your blank page, okay? You will make the title page on the blank page of your copy. Write on the top the unit number 18. In the middle area, you will write there this chapter name, The Story of Pakistan. After completion of it, you will make the outline of this chapter. Write the categories of the questions, short questions, descriptive, activity-based and challenging. There are six short, three descriptive questions, activity-based two, and challenging questions is only one. So this is your home task. Tomorrow we will discuss the remaining chapter of the story of Pakistan. Okay? So take care and Allah Hafiz.